This is probably the only place in America that I can go and be treated like Bruce Springsteen at a concert.
I'm just a fan of yours. Oh, well, we love okay. you.
Thank you.
Can I get a picture?
You sure can.
Santorum.
Yes, ma'am. How are you?
Great.
How are you?
Good to see you.
All right. Thank you.
Good to see you. Thank you.
Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Robbie Wade has got to go! Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Robbie Wade has got to go! Hey, hey!
The amazing thing is, these are people from all over the country. They're driven by a call. It is a civil rights call to protect those who are vulnerable. Think about the music. I mean, it's not what I would expect at a pro-life march. I mean, this is heavy, edgy, you know, beaten music.
We have three tenets. One, we want to share the gospel of Jesus' saving grace. Right. Two, we want to defend preborn people and other defenseless people worldwide. And three, we want to lead people into worshiping God. So, and we just do it through electronic dance music.
Thank you.
Mike Pence is showing up to speak today. I think that is huge for a signal to the pro-life community.
Life is winning again in America.
Sam and I were like the 1-2 punch pro-life warriors when I was in the Senate.
Awesome. Yeah.
You know each other, right?
Abby Johnson.
Hey, but there's nobody better to present the pro-life cause than Abby. Abby, go ahead.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I did. I worked for Planned Parenthood for 8 years, left in 2009. After witnessing a live ultrasound guided abortion procedure where I saw a baby fighting for his life in the womb. And I knew then that there was humanity there and that humanity had to be protected.
The people who run CNN don't know that we exist.
Why I'm here.
There are many women that we know that have had abortions. It's traumatized them. They can't tell their stories in the mainstream media. People tell them we're not interested in that story. That doesn't fit our narrative.
I'm pretty tall. As far as I can see, blocks and blocks ahead, it's Constitution Avenue is just full of people. It's always exciting to see so many people out here who care. I don't think people realize, because I get this from political people, you know, Republicans who say, you know, stay away from these issues. You know, people don't really care about them. And they just don't realize how many millions of people across this country care deeply about this human right.
Have you here?
I'm so happy you're here.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you're here. Why are you here?
Because every life matters.
And do you go to, what, Cornell?
No,
or
no, this is my cousin's hat.
Okay.
I'm a senior in high school.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good. Is this your first march?
It is, yes.
First march for you?
Yes.
So tell me your experience. First march, is it what you expected?
It's more than what I expected. I didn't think there would be this many people out here. Like, I'm not sure how the turnout is every year since this is my first one, and it's really great to know that there are other young people out there who feel the same way I do. Because sometimes it feels like you're a little isolated when you're pro-life, because a lot of young people today aren't pro-life, but it's really inspiring to come out here.
Where are you guys from?
In Laconia, New Hampshire.
Hey, up in the lake area, right?
Yeah.
I've been up there. It's a good place.
Yeah, it's great.
I know New Hampshire. Pro-life! God bless you. God bless you.